Hi and welcome to iSBI. Today I gonna make a play shopping cart for my daughter. For the basic construction I cut scrap pieces to square slats. Then I cut the pieces to the proper length on the miter saw. For the basket and the rolling base I need 3 frames. To make them I cut slot mortises and tenons at some of the pieces. For the basket I need many holes in the frames. I make them before I glue the frames together, because in this stage I can handle them easier. Some of the holes have to be drilled on a slight angle. I made a simple jig which acts as a guide and clamped it to the tilted drill press table. Then I glue the 2 frames for the basket together. For the rolling base I need some round wooden rods, so I cut them to length on the miter saw. To finish the rolling base frame, I glue 3 pieces of the frame together, stick the rods in and glue on the final piece. Here I drill the last holes in the basket frames. I give the frames a quick sanding and round off the sharp edges on my router table. For the casters of the rolling base, I drill a hole in each corner and screw in 4 threaded inserts. I mount the casters to the rolling base with screws and washers. I cut slot mortises and tenons to the vertical supports and the glued frames of the basket. I cut two more vertical supports from round rods. Then I glue the basic basket together. For the bottom of the basket I use 4mm plywood. For the card supports, which connects the rolling base with the basket later, I use 18mm spruce. I cut the main supports to length on the miter saw and cut an angle to one side of the support and to a short piece of spruce, so the handlebar is angled later. I cut the handlebar holders round on the bandsaw and sand it on the disc sander. As usual, I round off the sharp edges. To glue the handlebar holders to the main supports, I use dowels. I mark the position where I will drill the holes and figure out how deep they should be. Then I drill the holes in the handlebar holders with a dowel jig. To mark the positions of the holes in the main supports, I use center transfer plugs. I stick them in the already drilled holes in the handlebar holders and press them against the main supports to transfer the center points. Then I drill the holes in the main supports as well. and then I glue them together. To finish the basket, I stick wooden rods in the holes and trim them flush with a Japanese saw. I do that all around the whole basket. Then I glue all the rods in place. And after that, I glue on the bottom of the basket. Because I have cut the bottom oversized, I trim it flush and round off the edges. Now, where the main supports has dried, I drill blind holes for the handlebar. Here I drill holes to attach the main supports to the rolling base. In the holes of the rolling base, I screw in threaded inserts. To attach the basket to the main supports, I do the same steps as before, drilling holes in the main supports and mounting threaded inserts in the basket. To increase the stability of the main supports, I add two small additional supports. Then I assemble the whole shopping cart to check if all the parts fit together. To give the shopping cart a more girly look, I disassemble it and give it a paint job in grey and pink. A last assembling and the play shopping cart for my daughter is finished. Thank you. thank you for watching. If you liked this video, please subscribe, give it a thumb up, share, and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!